So I've got a request today. I want to ask all educators out there to stop saying make 10. Now, I know that making 10 is a huge deal in elementary school. It is a big, big thing that we need kids to understand. However, the term make 10 makes it very difficult for kids to extend beyond making 10. I'm Christina Tondevold, the Recovering Traditionalist, and I hope that you will stick around as we investigate making 10. Now, in my eyes, really, it's not about making 10, but about making it friendly. So we're going to stick around and investigate this in our quest to build our math minds so that we can build the math minds of our students. Now, making 10 is typically seen as an early elementary idea, which is one of the reasons why I want to get rid of it, because this idea spans beyond those early grades. So if you're an upper grades educator, stick around because this pertains to you as well. All right, so the general idea is that we want to help kids make it friendly. Now, making numbers friendly pertains beyond the whole make a 10 strategy that tends to be seen as kind of a kindergarten, first grade thing. But when we call it make it friendly, that idea, that strategy will stay with them and last in everything that they're going to be doing around mathematics. If you can make a problem friendly, it makes mathematics so much nicer. So let's take a look at a few examples here. So if we start out with this idea of 9 plus 7, so addition facts is kind of where it all starts, is that we try to help kids make a 10 because making a 10 makes it nicer. So if they can chunk off 1 from the 7, give it to the 9, then they can make a 10 and 6. And 10 and 6 is a much nicer problem. And I kind of almost gave it away there, but I like to say it's friendlier. Kids love that term friendly versus talking about benchmark numbers. I'm big about benchmark numbers, but that's not really a kid term. So when you're talking about it with students, I like to talk about it as make it friendly, because as they move forward and they're doing make it friendly, then as it extends into multi-digit addition, something like 299 plus 357, that problem, a lot of our students who only learned make a 10, make a 10, make a 10, they don't see how this problem can make a 10. And yes, we want kids to understand that they are really making a 10, but it's a whole lot easier transition if we can help them just make it friendly. What is a friendly number that we could maybe move one of those numbers to? And when we talk about it in that way, they can quickly see that 300 would make this so much friendlier, right? And then even as we advance into decimals, it's no longer making it 10. And again, if you want to be technical, yes, we are making a 10 somewhere in here, but every time we make a 10, it makes it friendly, which is the point I want to get across here, is that making a 10 limits our kids' thinking and it stunts them to think, I always have to make a 10, but they aren't really making a 10 in a lot of these situations in their eyes. So here, it's a whole lot nicer if we could make this friendly by making the 3 and 99 hundredths into 4. All we have to take is 1 hundredth off of the 17 hundredths. Now we've got 4 and 16 hundredths. That makes it so much more friendly. And we didn't really make a 10 in the kids' eyes. That's why it's so hard for them to transfer that make a 10 strategy. If you've ever had that situation where you're talking about make a 10 and then they aren't able to transfer it to new situations, it's because they really aren't seeing it as 10. When you talk about it as make it friendly, that becomes so much easier to transfer. Now let's even look as we move to fractions here, guys, because here is an instance where we aren't making a 10, but we could make one of those numbers friendly, and that would make the problem so much nicer. We've got 3.5 plus 5 3/4. Now, if you want us to play around with this for a little bit before I give some ways to make this friendly, pause the video here. So spoiler alert, I'm gonna talk about a way or two of how to make this friendly. Because if you've never really looked at fractions this way, this doesn't come natural. But if we look at it and try to think about how could I make one of those friendly? Some of you might want to make the 5 3/4 a nice number, a friendly number, because it's really close to 6. And all you need is just 1/4 more. Now, again, this is not like a quick, easy fix, because kids have to understand that in 3 1/2, there are some fourths. 3 1/2 is the same thing as 3 2/4. So we have a lot of work with developing number sense and everything else that goes into helping kids really understand this concept. But the idea of make it friendly is I need a fourth so that I could turn the 5 3/4 into 6. And if I understand that 3 1/2 is 3 2/4, I can take 1/4 away, and now I've made my number friendly. I have 6, and I'm left with 3 1/4. That is way nicer to add together. Now, some of you might have went the other way and said, well, 3 1/2, if I just have another half, I could make 4. And you know that a half is the same thing as 2/4. So you grab 2/4 from the 5 3/4, and you made the 3 1/2 4. It doesn't matter how you made it friendly, guys. The idea is that when you make it friendly, the problem is so much nicer. It's so much friendlier. That's why I like the term. It makes the problem friendlier to solve. So if you can make one of the numbers friendly, the world just opens up mathematically. And the other cool part that I love about this discussion when we're talking about making it friendly is all the number sense that comes up. Because kids have to decide what would be friendly. Why is that friendly? Why is 300 friendly here, but 4 is friendly here? So you get to build all of this kind of number sense around numbers that you don't get to when we just say, make a 10, make a 10, make a 10. Okay, now I hope I've made the case that I want you to move away from make a 10 into make it friendly. Now I want to give you some ideas of how to help kids develop this in the classroom. Now, this is a short video. If you want more info, I have some free upcoming webinars, and there's links below to get registered for those. There's one for the lower grades, and then there's one for the upper grades. So if you're interested, want more, join one of the webinars, because it's just a short little piece of it. But there's two big things that I want to talk about in this video. Number one is that the model that you choose to do these make a 10 or make it friendly strategies does not matter. I don't care what your textbook is trying to get you to do, the model doesn't matter. I have seen way too many kids get stuck on trying to fill out a number bond that they aren't even paying attention to what the big idea is. They get so stuck in which number goes where inside of the number bond, or maybe you're using a part-part whole model. Whatever model you're using, the model doesn't matter. The mathematics is what matters. They don't even have to model it. They just need some way to write it. Now, in the previous examples that we just talked about, I was just kind of saying it. I wasn't showing a model for it. But the idea of a number bond is to show how the whole number can be broken apart into pieces, but then you could use those pieces to compose and make a new amount. So the general idea that you want to help kids understand is this idea of decomposing a number and then composing a number back together. And I don't care if you use number bonds, if you just write it down as equations, it doesn't matter, guys. The idea is the mathematics. So free yourself if your textbook is having them do it in a particular model and the kids are just getting stuck on the model. It's okay to not use that model and try something else. The idea is we want them to see that they can break it apart, put some over here with the 9, and then make it friendly, and then what's left over to still have to add together. That's it. That's all we've got to do, okay? That model does not matter. Okay, the second thing is I really want to encourage you to use that term friendly. And I already alluded to this, but I talk a lot about it as benchmark numbers because mathematicians talk about it in that way. Math educators talk about benchmark numbers, but kids don't often relate to that. So switching our terminology to friendly numbers, and you can interchange friendly benchmark, I don't really care. But you got to start with making it friendly for kids. And friendly is a friendly term. I just said that way too many times, but you get the idea, right? So I wanted to show you another little example because I just did addition stuff. And the cool part about this whole friendly numbers is that it applies as we're doing all the operations. So we can do subtraction, but I really wanted to hit home multiplication and division because these are really sticking points for our upper grades kids. And when you can make it friendly and help them make the problem friendly, oh, it's so much nicer. So let's take a look at a typical fact, okay? And this applies to multi-digit, but again, I'm trying to keep these videos short, so think about how it would apply to what you're teaching now. But if we're doing 7 times 8, a lot of times sevens are not friendly for our kids. Most of the time, kids think about this as 7 groups of 8. Well, doing 7 groups of 8 is not friendly. And you guys, yes, we could just make them memorize, but again, it's about building their math minds, not just creating calculators. So we want to build their thinking processes. And 7 groups of 8 is not very friendly. But in multiplication, there are certain multiplication facts that are friendly. Your 2s, your 5s, your 10s, kids gravitate towards those, and those are friendly. So if I need 7 groups of 8, I could do 5 groups of 8 and 2 groups of 8 and then put those together. So if we can help kids see how to make the problem friendly, it gives them another way to think about the problem. So as you move into division, this is like one of my favorite ways of all times that the moment I saw this forever changed how I thought about mathematics. But when long division, our students are notoriously horrible with long division, especially when there's that instance where there's going to be a zero in there. Kids will often forget the zero. There's just a whole lot of room for error in this whole long division thing. And it doesn't build number sense. But if you help kids think about how can we make this friendly? So the whole idea here is, when we do long division, typically what we teach kids is, okay, we set it up differently, right? And we say, how many times will 2 go into 4? And then we multiply that, bring it down, subtract, all of that fun stuff, and then 2 into 0. And they'll say no times, and they forget to put their 0 up there. So they go through this whole process. But if they look at it as the whole problem, this is really asking us 4,064 divided by 2. Well, 4,064 divided by 2 isn't friendly, but guess what is? There are problems within that that are friendly. 4,000 divided by 2 is super friendly, 60 divided by 2 is friendly, and 4 divided by 2 is friendly. And if you do 4,000 divided by 2, which is 2,000, 60 divided by 2, which is 30, and then 4 divided by 2, which is 2, it's 2,032, right? And I did that in my head. Kids, I often might show that sometimes in a number bond if kids are familiar with that. You can show each equation there and list it all out. And then the answer is right there for them. And I know some people often say, well, this is a lot of work. Oh my gosh, guys, if you've ever taught long division, you know how difficult that is. And yes, this is an easy problem. It's a friendly problem. But you start with friendly problems so they get the idea of what division is about, so that even as they move into more difficult problems, they're still looking for friendly chunks that they can pull out of that division problem. All right, some final tips about how to help make it friendly for your students. Now, I am a big believer in visuals, but visuals that help emphasize relationships. So for the young grades, I really love Wreck and Wrecks and 10 frames because they emphasize those tens. And as you move into multiplication, I even love the Wreck and Wrecks where you can add a row and you can get up to 12 rows of 10 because it helps emphasize those friendly amounts. I even love putting multiplication inside of 10 frames because it helps kids see groupings. The whole idea is whatever visuals you're using help kids see groupings. And that's another reason why I don't really love the number bonds, because it doesn't help kids see the actual groupings. It's just the abstract digits inside of the number bond. My other favorite way is to do strings of problems. Now, the whole idea of a string is you can do a string to lead into a certain strategy, or you can do a string that helps emphasize a certain pattern or relationship. So here's a little string for addition that I might do with younger grades kids. And as you notice, every single one of them has a 7. The idea of this string is to talk about what can we break off to make the 7 a friendly number? Because we want kids to see that no matter what we're adding to a 7, you always want to chunk off a 3. And I know some of you might get a little bothered with the bottom one where it says 7 plus 9, because a lot of you want to break off a 1 and give it to the 9 to make that friendly. But again, you guys, it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter which number they make friendly as long as they are making a number friendly. And I would have that specific conversation with them about who wanted to break off 1 and move it over to the 9. Why'd you want to do that? If we didn't break some off and make the 7 friendly, how would we make that friendly? So we want to help them see that consistency so that we can move into a larger string with larger amounts as we're moving into multi-digit addition to help them see that still, if there's a 7, anytime that there was a 7, we're chunking off a 3 or something with a 3. Like at that bottom one, if I had made that 287, right? We wouldn't just want a 3, we'd want a 13. So we want to help them see patterns, and doing number strings is a great way to help them see those patterns in how we make problems friendly. Well, I hope that this video has helped you build your math mind so you can build the math minds of your students. And remember, it's all about making it friendly. And if you want more friendly tips to help you build your students' fluency with addition and multiplication, I've got some upcoming free trainings. Just click the link below to get registered. I would love to see you on one of those. Have a great day.